Once upon a time, right around here, my grandfather bought land near the headwaters of the Yuba River. The year was 1948, 26 years after the last Wolverine was seen in California. 66 years later, I found out our neighbors would be essentially clear-cutting up to 120 acres. I was curious who would be around to notice, so I followed the property line and started setting up cameras. What I found changed the way I see the forest forever. These carnivorous sundews are the first to drink the Yuba River at this natural spring 7,000 feet above sea level. Just south of the logging area is the Tahoe National Forest with a 30,000 acre block of connected forest. This part of the Sierras is so nice, one Wolverine walked 500 miles from Idaho and has called this area home for over 6 years. My friends told me they saw the Wolverine near the logging area, but somehow I just kept filming squirrels. Then again, these were the same friends who once claimed they found a fossilized crocodile. Finally, a mother black bear with cubs showed up. Two days later, another big black bear meandered through. And then the following week, Mom and the cubs showed up again. In the 60s, my grandfather had serious problems with hunters trespassing on his property. To combat this safely, he installed microphones and speakers in the trees and would remotely talk to trespassers and tell them of their crime. In 1971, he wrote this: "Over the years, the quail and the coyotes, the bear, the lion, the trout, the bobcat, and the grouse have disappeared to the trigger-happy sportsmen who fail to see the flowers, the ferns, the trees, the geologic display, and its history, except through the sights of their weapons. But still much of nature's story survives, and our always welcome nature visitors have much left to enjoy and photograph." He passed away in 1972, and I wish that he could see these images today and know that we haven't blown it yet. The black bear, the coyote, the bobcat, they're still here. In fact, a new animal has returned to the Sierras. This is Buddy, the first Wolverine to come home in 90 years. Here in the Golden State, we hunted the California golden bear to extinction, so this subspecies that's on our flag is gone forever. We also lost our Wolverines, but the same species is still alive in nearby states. Animals naturally repopulate an ecosystem. Buddy is here, and for 6 years he's been looking for ladies. Every animal is important in an ecosystem, just like every bolt in your car. Hopefully California will follow suit with other states who are reintroducing animals who belong in an ecosystem. Buddy the Wolverine deserves a chance. Females don't wander great distances like males, but we can easily bring him a female from up north so that he can start a family. As far as my neighbors logging their 120 acres, time will tell. From my uneducated observations, it seems my neighbors are working to minimize their impacts of logging. They know to watch out for the sundews in the meadow, about the waterways and the aspen groves, and they know about Buddy the Wolverine. It is their land, so they get to manage it how they want. Luckily though, you and I get that 30,000 acre block next door, called the Tahoe National Forest. The Yuba River watershed is spectacular and worth exploring. In the words of my grandfather, we hope your visit will be enjoyable, restful, and inspirational.